Le ministre des Enseignements secondaires a développé une plateforme d'enseignement à distance pour les élèves du secondaire au Cameroun. Une série d'enseignements dispensés par les enseignants de qualité pour les élèves du secondaire. Apprendre n'a jamais été aussi simple avec l'enseignement à distance. Une initiative du ministère des Enseignements secondaires sous la supervision du professeur Nalova Lyonga en collaboration avec le ministère des Postes et Télécommunications, la CAMTEL, la CIRTV et l'UNESCO. Nous introduisons l'enseignement à distance comme une autre méthode d'enseignement et d'apprentissage qui diffère du cadre de classe traditionnel auquel vous êtes habitué. Dans le mode d'enseignement à distance, vous n'êtes pas avec l'enseignant en personne, alors prenez votre temps, détendez-vous, écoutez l'enseignant, prenez des notes et visitez les liens suivants pour toutes questions ou réponses à vos préoccupations. Allez-y à votre rythme! La solution du Cameroun contre le Covid-19 et au-delà. Professeur Nalova Lyonga, ministre des Enseignements secondaires.
Welcome to the distance learning session. We are going to continue our lessons in geography from one. I'm Mr. Bakoto Bayo. In the last class, we were discussing about the calculation of time, and we explained the notion of local time and standard time. We explained that the local time is the time on a specific degree of longitude, and that there are 360 degrees of longitude, and that there's a difference of 4 minutes between one degree of longitude and the other. We equally explained the notion of standard time, that is the time attributed to a group of 15 degrees of longitude. So that time shares the globe into time zones, and we saw that there are 24 time zones on the globe, and that as we move from the central meridian moving to the east, the time is increasing from the DMT. Why? When we are moving away from the central meridian and moving to the west, the time is instead reducing compared to the GMT. We saw how we can determine the time, how to calculate the time, and we explained the steps. We saw that the first step is that you determine the longitude difference. When you determine the longitude difference, you either divide by 15 to have the time in hours, or you multiply by 4 to have the time in minutes. Then after, you determine either you have to add or to subtract. We add the time difference to the DMT if the place is found to the east. But if the place is found to the west, we subtract the time from the GMT. So I give an assignment after that we are going to correct together. So the assignment was, what is the local time of Cape Verde on longitude 30 degrees west if the GMT is 10 a.m. So we are going to follow the steps together and solve that assignment. Step one is longitude difference. So we have thirty degrees for Cape Verde minus the longitude of the GMT. The GMT is always at longitude 0 degrees. So we have 30 degrees minus 0 degrees, which is 30 degrees. Now step two, either we divide by 15, or we multiply by 4. When we divide by 15, our answer is in hours. When we multiply by 4, our answer is in minutes. So we have here 30 divided by 15, which is 2 hours. And here we have 30 times 4, which is 120 minutes, which is equal to 2 hours, because 1 hour is 60 minutes. Now step three. We add, step three, we add the time to the DMT if the place is found east of the DMT, and we subtract if it is found west of the DMT. So from our example, it is 30 degrees west. So we are supposed to subtract from the DMT. So we have DMT minus 2 hours. So we have the DMT was 10. So it's 10 minus 2 hours, which is 8 a.m. Okay. So this is the booking. Longitude 30 minus 0, which is 30. Multiplied by 4, you have 30 times 4, which is 120 minutes, which is 2 hours. So the DMT is 10 a.m. Then, since it is found west of the DMT, you subtract 2 hours from the DMT. So we have 10 a.m. minus 2 hours, which is 8 a.m. So our lesson for today is on the moon, phases of the moon and effects. Our lesson overview is previous knowledge, what you are supposed to know to better understand this lesson. You're going to put yourself in a real life situation and tell me what you can do to avoid that situation. I'm going to explain why this lesson is important and give you what you are supposed to do and know at the end of this lesson. You are going to enter into the lesson properly. Then I will give some exercises. So, have you ever seen the moon? I'm sure you have already seen the moon. What is the moon? Do you know what is a moon? How does the moon usually appear? Which human activity is related to the appearance of the moon? We're going to answer those questions. John is preparing the Ramadan. You know the Ramadan, no? The Muslim feast. John is preparing the Ramadan. He did not know when it was going to take place. Thus, he did not prepare well. So finally, he was sad of missing such an important event. What do you think he should do next time to avoid missing such an event? He can observe the moon every day at night. During the period, he knows the Ramadan is supposed to take place, to see if the new moon will appear. So this lesson is important because it will make you to understand how the phases of the moon appear. At times you look in the sky, you see the moon. The moon seems to be a crescent. At times it is a ball, complete ball. At times it is a half ball. So this lesson will make you understand how those different phases occur and how they affect human activities like feasting, shipping, and hunting. So at the end of this lesson, you should use the knowledge acquired on the phases of the moon to plan activities like fishing, hunting, and feasting. When should you feast? When should you hunt? When should you feast? So, the moon is the natural satellite of the earth. When we talk of satellite, means the moon is turning around the earth. as it is turning around the earth, it takes 29 and a half day to complete a full revolution, like the revolution of the earth where the earth was turning around the sun. Now in this case, it is the moon. We are talking of the movement of the moon around the earth, so making the moon to be the satellite of the earth. Now, why is it that when you look at the moon in the night, the moon is shining? It is because the moon is reflecting light from the sun. It is like a mirror. When you put the mirror under the sun and you forward it towards somebody, the person is receiving the sun. So that is why we see the moon to be shining. It is taking its light from the sun and simply reflecting it on the earth. Now the moon has different phases. Let's see the different phases of the moon. I'm sure you have already seen these different phases. At times you don't see the moon. At times you see the moon having this shape. At times you see the moon having this other shape. At times you see this. At times you see this. This. This one. This one. And then after, the moon disappears again. So, why is the moon changing phases? See, we have our sun here. Our sun. We have the earth here. You see this small ball. It is the moon. And you see the moon is turning around the earth. You see that on this small ball, you have a part which is white and a part which is dark. The part which is white is the part that is facing the sun. So the sun is coming on that part, while the other part of the moon is receiving darkness. So you see, depending on the position of the moon around the earth, the portion of the sun rays reflected by the moon that we can see from earth changes. So as that portion is changing, we have different phases of the moon. For example, in this first case, we are on earth. The moon is facing the sun. So this part here of the moon has light, while the other part that we can see from earth is dark. So at that period, we don't see the moon because the moon is dark. So this face of the moon will appear. So at that moment, the moon will be absent from the sky. At this other moment, you see, the position of the moon has changed. It means the sun rays reflected by the moon that we can see from earth will also change. At this moment, this is what we are going to see. So at this other moment, we are going to have equator, like a half moon. We're going to see the half moon. Why? Because of the reflection of the earth. At that moment, we can only see half of the moon that is reflecting the sun. So we have the phases of the moon. We have the new moon, the waxing crescent. We have the first quarter. We have the waxing gibbous. We have the full moon. We have the waning gibbous. We have the last quarter, then the waning crescent, then the new moon. So that is how the moon is changing for 29 and a half day, almost a month. At times it appears, it starts increasing, reaches the full moon, then starts reducing again, then disappears. That is for the phases of the moon. And remember, we explained that it is because of the light received from the sun that is reflected by the moon, that we can see the moon, and that the position of the moon around the earth makes that the portion which is reflecting the light that we can see from earth is changing. Therefore, the phases are also changing. So we have the new moon, the crescent, the first quarter, the gibbous, the full moon, the third quarter, and the last crescent. Why is it important to study the phases of the moon? First point, moonrise and moonset are suitable for fishing. Why do you think moonrise and moonset are suitable for fishing? At that moment, when the sunrise and sunset, we have light. And since there is light, fish can go closer to the surface to hunt, because when there is darkness, they cannot see their prey. So when there is light, they are able to see their prey and to run away from predators. So they will be closer to the surface. Therefore, at that time, it will be easy for people to throw their net and carry a lot of fish. That is one advantage of studying the phases of the moon, to know when to carry out fishing. Now, the second point, the full moon is suitable for hunting. It's almost the same case as the one for fishing. When there's the full moon, there's a lot of light. At times, when there's the full moon, you can even see you can see at night and walk as if you are walking the day. You can see the road very well. At times, you don't even need the street light to lighten your way. You can see the way clearly. So the animals equally, when there's the full moon, they can see their predators. So they feel safe to move out and to feed. Therefore, at that moment, it is suitable for hunting, since many animals are out to look for their food. So it's a good moment for hunting. Now, the feast of the Ramadan is celebrated after the moon appears. There's a period where people fast, and they know that after the period of fasting, they are supposed to start the feast of the Ramadan. Now, what is showing the end of the fasting? It is the appearance of the moon. At times, you may hear that the moon has appeared maybe in North Cameroon, but has not appeared in other parts of the world. Or you hear that the moon has not yet appeared in Cameroon, but has appeared in Saudi Arabia. And the next day, people are supposed to feast the Ramadan. Why is it that we are not seeing the moon, the first moon, at the same time? Remember that concerning the shape of the earth, we saw that the earth is spherical. So as the earth is turning, different places will see the moon at different periods of time. So the appearance of the new moon marks the beginning of the Ramadan. Exercise. Number one, how long does it take for the moon to revolve around the earth? How long does it take for the moon to revolve around the earth? Question two, why is the moon changing phases? Why is the moon changing phases? Question three, list some human activities influenced by the phases of the moon. Correction, the moon makes a complete revolution every 29 and a half days. We explained that since the moon is turning around the earth, the moon is considered as the natural satellite of the earth. We have many satellites. that are sent into space to observe distant places. But those are man-made satellites. But the moon is not made by man, and it is turning around the Earth. So it is a natural satellite. So it takes 29 and a half days to complete its revolution. Question two, the answer for question two. The revolution of the moon makes us to see the reflection of the sun rays differently. The question was, why is it that we have different phases of the moon at different periods of the month? Because you remember the diagram having the different phases of the moon. You remember this diagram. Remember this diagram. That as the moon is turning around the Earth, you see the sun is reflected on the moon. You have a portion of the moon that is receiving light, but the other portion is receiving darkness. So depending on the position of the moon, like in this case, we have the moon which is facing the sun. Therefore, the face of the moon that is towards the Earth is dark. Therefore, we don't see the moon. We have the new moon. Now, this other position, you see the sun is reflecting on the moon. So we are able to see a greater part of the moon. Therefore, this other shape will appear. So in this other case, we are able to see half of the moon. So this other will appear. You remember this other one also, as it is still moving around the Earth, a greater part, you see, the part which is receiving the sun, we are able to see. So it is almost, we can see almost all of the part that is reflecting the solar rays. Now in this other case, you see, the face which is towards the sun is also towards the Earth. Therefore, we can see the total surface which is reflecting the sun. Therefore, we have a full moon. After some time, that portion reflecting is reducing again, and we have another phase of the moon. And same thing here, it is still moving. So the portion is reducing, it is still moving, the portion is reducing, it is still moving, then the portion is reducing, it is still moving, and then the portion is reducing. Therefore, for the 29 and a half day during which the Earth is turning, like you can see, it is starting here, turning gradually, until it will reach its original position. It will make a complete revolution in 29 and a half day. So after 29 and a half day, we are going to have a complete revolution of the moon, and then we are going to see all the different phases of the moon that are changing. So the question three, list some human activity influenced by the phases of the moon. We have fishing, we have hunting, we have feasting the Ramadan. We explained that for the case of fishing, when there's light from the moon, the fish is able to see the prey on the surface and the predators, so they feel safe to look for their food. So they will move to the surface, and then it will be easy to throw your net and to catch the fish. Now, for hunting, the animals, the preys are like man. Normally, they cannot see in darkness, but when there's a full moon, the preys can see, and the preys generally eat grass, and they run away from their predators like the lion, like the tigers. So when it's the full moon, they feel safe to move out to look for their food. And they know that if the predator comes, they will see the predator from far away and they will hide themselves. So hunting during the full moon, it is easy to hunt because the animals are outside. Many of them are out to look for their food. Therefore, at the full moon, it is easy to hunt. Now for the feasting of the Ramadan, we saw that after a particular period of the year, the Muslim, they fast. And they know that after the period of fasting, they are supposed to start the feast of the Ramadan. And what is telling them that the fasting is over is the appearance of the new moon. So after the new moon is shown, they know that the Ramadan is supposed to start. And they organize the feast, they invite their friends, the family members, and they enjoy together. So assignment, you are going to give me the list of the different phases of the moon for our next class. So the following references were consulted in order to produce these lessons. So in our next class, we are going to discuss on the Earth as a blue planet.
Tam 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 t